like to add my very personal thanks and welcome to the parents of our Year 12 2021 graduating class and to the teachers and staff members that are here as well. This is being Zoomed and it's going to be live streamed to the students around the school, so I hope you appreciate that. Welcome now to the Year 12 2021 Awards Ceremony. I would like to thank Father Ronnie for not only celebrating the beautiful liturgy here today and the wonderful message from Father Ronnie in his homily, but also for the generosity and continual support of our LaSalle community. It is very much appreciated by staff, students and parents alike. With respect, we acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land LaSalle stands upon, the Darug Nation's peoples. We are honoured to have been able to use this site for the purpose of providing a quality education for these young men and women who sit before us today. In doing so, we also recognise the richness brought to us from the diverse traditions and cultures gathered here. May we always walk gently on this land. This is a milestone occasion for Year 12. Their past 2 years, I don't like mentioning it, but their past 2 years will be remembered as the COVID class of 2021. But it has been a year of transformation. 7 years ago, these young men and women and I began our LaSallean journey together. I say 7 years ago, when I started visiting feeder primary schools and encouraging the parents and students to join LaSalle's first co-educational journey from year 7 through to year 12. It was an exciting and frenetic time, to say the least. I remember once reading author, I cannot remember, I apologise, but I remember reading these words. Those who show dignity and respect, those who lead without seeking acknowledgement, those who care for one another, especially the young, and those who strive to do their best in any circumstance. These are the kind of people I want to be amongst. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2021 are all of these attributes and more. Since taking up the historical challenge of being the first LaSallean Year 7 cohort, this group have proven to be young men and women of respect and dignity. They have led without seeking reward. They have always cared for others and been an exemplary model for the younger years. They have been a pleasure to be with. I congratulate them, graduating in an excellent manner, one on which they can truly be proud, one on which they can now go forth to share their talents and gifts to others they will meet. This year, the awards will be presented in alphabetical order, listing the awards after each student's name. As each student comes forward towards the table, to have your photo taken with Mr. Eden. Yep. If you are the recipient of a perpetual award, a large trophy will be placed on the table. Please leave that on the table and take the pewter trophy with you. Some of the awards will identify the most diligent and hardworking students from each class. These students have consistently demonstrated the desire to take advantage of all the opportunities afforded to students at LaSalle and have responded to the challenge to ensure they give their best in all they do. Or they may be awarded to students who have been placed first in each of their subjects. Like our previous category, these recipients have also demonstrated a significant commitment towards their studies and have been rewarded appropriately with outstanding academic success. Finally, some will win major awards, recognising achievement in sport or endurance, the Australian Defence Force innovators and leadership qualities, or extraordinary service to the community. This year, we are presenting each student with a gift from the college as a memento of being the first co-educational cohort. Mr. Jacobs will speak about this gift a little bit later on. I sincerely hope you remember LaSalle with fond memories. I hope that you'll always walk gently in the footsteps of Jesus and continue God's hospitality on earth as you do so. I now invite Mr. Jacobs and Mr. Deacon to come forward to present portfolios and speak the word.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to announce the Academic Achievement, Excellence, and Special Awards for 2021. Please hold your applause until the end. Nicholas Abdon, English Standard 1, Industrial Technology, Timber. Jocelyn Abelson. Loren Vesta, Visual Arts, Academic Achievement. George Alfred Hill, Special Award, Rotary Youth Vocational Award 2021, Academic Achievement, Automotive. Charvella Tiller. Margaret Bashu. John Benitez, level 2. Christina Mesquera, Special Award, ADF Long-Term Leadership and Teamwork Award, Academic Excellence, Ancient History, Investigative Science, Academic Achievement, Biology. Chloe Bozanowski. Jessica Booby. Alex Bowari, Sportsman of the Year and Best and Fairest A Grade Rugby League, A Grade Basketball. Jessica Rodriguez, Academic Achievement, Studies of Religion 1. In Daniela Carini's absence, she's won quite a few awards, so just bear with me. The Brother Michael Johnson Award for Academic Excellence, CityLink Mentor Program, Academic Excellence in Economics, English Advanced, English Extension 1, English Extension 2, Academic Achievement, Biology, Studies of Religion 1. Anthony Shadeda, Academic Health Excellence in English Studies, Best and Fairest, A-grade Soccer. Daniel Shaheen, Special Award, K.E. Maroney Award for College Leadership, Academic Excellence, Biology, Physics, Academic Achievement, Business Studies, English Advanced, Mathematics Advanced. Tiana Sivkorowska. Christian Savinovsky, Academic Excellence in Business Studies, Mathematics Standard 2, BDL PE, Academic Achievement, Biology, English Standard 1. Jack Dutt.
Yeah.
George Daoud, academic achievement in construction. Joseph Daoud, special award, Rotary Youth Vocational Award 2021, academic achievement in construction. Jeff Diep. Beatrice Dos Santos Rivera. Jessica Duffy, academic excellence in drama. Peter Duong. Sophia Fendi, special award, Brother Ambrose Award for Outstanding Courage in Achievement, Academic Achievement in Legal Studies. Hamza El Hajj. Jumit El Taha. Billy Francis, academic excellence, legal studies, academic achievement, construction. Jack Galvin Valencia, most improved A grade basketball. That is, yeah. Archbishop of Sydney Award for Student Excellence, Principals Award Level 1, Academic Excellence, Mathematics Advanced, Mathematics Extension 1, Academic Achievement, English Advanced. Jerome George. Edmund Genham, academic excellence, industrial technology, English Standard 1 academic achievement, and Mathematics Standard 1 academic achievement. Aaron Gooding, special award. The Spirit of LaSalle Award, City Link Mentor Program. Leah Gritter. Dr. Brozanovsky. Samuel Gunnar. Julianne Quebec, St. Vincent de Paul Award, special award for that. Cameron Hubbard. Raj Haber, the CityLink Mentor Program. Junior Ramsey. Justin Hannah. academic achievement, investigative science, and mathematics standard 2. Laura Hannah, academic excellence, community and family studies, studies of religion 1. Justin Hobb. Joseph Hare. Not this way. Like Aisha. Jamie Jaja, academic excellence, mathematics excellence retreat. Hello, Chibo. Amina, telephone. Amazing. John Canal. Joseph Campbell. Johnny Curry. Yeah, Michelle. Anastasia Lajmanov. Savannah Lennon. Natalie Lawani, Special Award, K.E. Moroni Award for College Leadership, Academic Achievement, Economics, and Hospitality. Grace Levy. Check it. Trumley. Elvis Live. Stanley Ma. Daniel Mack. Jonathan McGoo. Luca Markovsky. Peter Maggio. Yeah. Younger McGill, special award, Ample Award for the best all-rounder, academic excellence, studies in Catholic thought, level 2 award. Patrick Hackenbach. Aaron McMullen. Shada Mahena, academic achievement studies in Catholic school. George Mensa, special award, support leadership award. Milan Maletic. Then Reginovsky, academic achievement, HDS. Jake Whitten. Massimo Morelli. Most of the group, 8th grade, right to leave. In the note. Alexander Newman. Eric Newman, 4.3. Eric Newman, 4.4. Ethan Newman, academic achievement, industrial technology, multimedia. Huey Newman, special award, Vincent DePaul Award, Jason Clare, MP Community Award, academic achievement, PDLP. Martina Newman. Ben Newman, academic achievement, mathematics standard. Jason Nam, special award, Rofi Youth Vocational Award 2021. Zia Noor. Andre Novichis. Harry Arusu, Mary McKillop Award for Extraordinary Service to the Community, and a level 2. Jillian Fan. Jacob Quinn, Special Award, LaSalle IBL Award, and Academic Achievement. Love it.
Oh, great.
You said that you're in Raha. Anthony Raymond Saba, the Special Award, Tanya Mahalo Award. Christian Sima. Georgia Sarah. Both improved, A grade stops. Isabella Silvera, the Year Coordinator's Award, Academic Excellence, English Standard, Academic Achievement, Business Studies, Community and Family Studies. Hayden Freeman. Margaret Kojanov. David Sebastian, the New York Yankees. Martin Trent. Academic Achievements. Sorry, Colin. Jason Trent, Academic Achievement Committee. Anna Tran, Academic Excellence in Visual Arts. Brandon Trump. Kevin Chu, Academic Achievement in Electro Technology. Savita Tupola. Martina Belchanovka. Marianne, Chuck, Billy Bow. Special award, Ruben has stopped award for commitment, persistent effort, academic achievement, mathematical advance, mathematical station one, physics, studies of religion one. And Michael. The South Vocational Education Award, Mathematics Standards, Academic Excellence, One, and Academic Achievement, English Study. Would you please give him a round of applause, everyone?
Thank you, Mr. Jacobs and Mr. Egan, and congratulations once again to the class of 2021. I'm Isabella Savara to present the Year 12 gift to the college. As you should be aware, it is customary for the graduating Year 12 class to present a gift to the college as a way of giving something back and as a tangible symbol of gratitude.
The new Hart building will be a great value to the future students. On behalf of Year 12, we are honored to present the gift voucher to the college. I hope our Lasanian brothers in one
bag. No, try to put the whole thing in the bag. Yeah. If you can.
Thank you, Faris and Isabel. I now invite the captains for 2021, Daniel Shaheen and Natalie Olivani to the stage.
Well, it almost felt like this moment would never come, but here we are. It's been an interesting 6 years, especially the past two, and I doubt we'll be forgetting them anytime soon. But for the graduating class of 2021, this year and the many which preceded will soon enough become a memory, and one that we look back on fondly with a sense of accomplishment and joy. Heck, we haven't even forgotten our earliest days. I'm sure we will remember the daunting gates of this prime school as we walk through on day one. In our munchkin-sized uniforms, a little large for our primary schoolish body, because our parents insisted that we grew into them. And as the first group of boys and girls to run the green turfs of La Salle, we had quite a ways to go. Thankfully, our year 7 days were kept in good hands. Our year coordinator, Mr. Carpage, led us well and made the transition from primary school to high school as easy as possible. These were our earliest days, yet in his recount in the 2016 La Salle yearbook, he foreshadowed our growth into the young adults we are today. In his words, we would have faced the future with the amazing strength of character that we displayed in our young age. And by God, was he right. With our loose-fitting blazers and oversized shoes, we stumbled through the old B block, and the tall towering seniors, not knowing that this journey would shape us into the respectable young men and women who live out the values of La Salle in our everyday lives. As our school was changing and growing, so were we. Fast forwarding for the next 2 years that followed, and our grade was in the hands of the great Mr. Weinberger, who encouraged us all to be the best versions of ourselves that we could be. Amidst the blur of the past, notable memory from these 2 years would have to be duct taping teachers to this gym wall right here as part of a charitable initiative. They're now a humorous fragment of the past. The memory of helplessly duct taping teachers to the wall remains entertaining all these years later. Maybe next time we can try it on the ceiling. But by now, our shoes and shirts and blazers seem to fit us just about right. And we were old enough to look humorously at the new year sevens entering the school, while at the same time watching the previous seniors disappear. By 2019, year 10 had already come around, and so too did Papa Goose, the man, the myth, and the legend, Mr. Jacobs. And we couldn't have been more blessed. Without him, who would remind us to wear the correct uniform day in, day out? Who would we have to remind us to get the little things right about setting the standard, about the tides and the rapids? Who would tell us about the geese? Jokes aside, these valuable messages and mantras were heard, and they served us well. We had a strong foundation upon which we would build ourselves up and the perfect coordinator to do so. Instilled in us was a sense of commitment to our growth as we fought to achieve our goals with confidence and pursued success with a sense of pride. As we matured, we grew closer together, not only as a cohort, but as friends, while at the same time developing a liberating independence. We'd come a long way already.
Onwards with our journey into year 11 and 12, we were introduced to a new student. Though not very welcome, we had to live with her, the notorious COVID-19. As if summing up that some 13 years of schooling wasn't daunting enough, we had a global viral pandemic to keep us occupied. Through this, though this hadn't stopped us in our tracks, on we went on a journey that felt like an aimless march through an endless dark room, waiting for the lights to turn on. However, many lockdowns later, reschedulings, delays, and interruptions garnished by the surrounding ever-changing environment, and we sat in anticipation. Eventually, we found ourselves sitting our last exam, relieved that the lights had finally been turned on. I won't sugarcoat the experience. Things became difficult and everyone's sense of motivation was challenged. We all dealt with our fair share of challenges, not only my peers and I, but our teachers and our families. But this was all just a reminder that there is no script to life, as unprecedented times like this can happen anytime. But our resilience, motivation, and strive for greatness can make it all good. In the words of Albert Einstein, in the middle of every difficulty lies opportunity. We assure you that being here today is a celebration of yourself. I especially direct this to the graduates of 2021. That you should take pride and admiration in the fact that you had it about yourselves amid times like this. I'd like to say I'm extremely proud of each of everyone for your efforts this year. And I pray for that your futures are filled with happiness, success, and prosperity. We leave you all this final note to remember why the windshield is larger than the rearview mirror. As we are called to focus passionately on the futures we make for ourselves that lie ahead of us and be reminded of all which we have overcome in our past that now lies behind us. To the teachers and the greater Lausannean community, thank you for facilitating our growth and maturation into the fine, resilient, capable young ladies and gentlemen we are today. And to the graduates and to the graduating class of 2021, the first co-educational cohort to graduate from LaSalle. Thank you all for making these years as memorable, enjoyable, laughable, and valuable, especially as we face our shared challenges.
Thank you, LaSalle, and best wishes to each and every one of you attendees.
Thank you, Daniel and Evelyn. Just listening to those words, they certainly have come a long, long way since you said it. Very nice. Could I call by Paris and Isabel back to the stage, please?
As we conclude our time as student college leaders, it has been our privilege to represent the student body and be positive role models for each student at the college. Mr. Jacobs inspired our new group to be the light of the world. It is our hope that by shining our own light, that we have helped the light of others in our community shine brighter.
Today, we symbolically pass this light onto the 2022 college chapter. As representatives of the student leadership group, we pray and hope that you may let your own light shine and make a lasting difference in our college community and be a model of Lausannean ideals. Take this candle from Daniel and Natalie as a symbol and sign to let your light shine.
As we thank our college captains, we also congratulate our 2022 college captains. Special thanks to Natalie and Daniel. It's a been a difficult year captaining a school when most of it was from home. This morning was the very first time our house leaders and our college captains and vice captains actually got to carry the banners down the aisle. They've never done so, and they did it with Alex with pride to me. Absolutely. Thank you very much. Can we congratulate and thank all the captains? I now invite Mother Goose.
Well, good morning, parents, teachers, students, and the graduating class of 2021. See you made it. Thank you and goodbye. Sorry. There's an old Chinese proverb that says, better to light the candle than to curse the darkness. We've been lighting a lot of candles in this complex. Recently, I came upon a reflection which said, when asked if my cup is half full or half empty, my only response is, I'm thankful I have a cup. Well, over the last 3 years, good people, my cup has runneth over. It's been a blessing in disguise. No, really. A blessing that just doesn't want to end. Ladies and gentlemen, as I said, we've been lighting a lot of candles over the past 2 years. And subsequently, as a focus for our senior years, we were guided by the affirming message in the Gospel of Matthew. And I mean this, because you know I don't say things that I don't mean. You are the light of the world. Let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. And we were also guided by the message found in our theme song, Shine. If you want it, you can have it. Just put aside your fears and just move on. Keep the faith and find the courage. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, you will shine. And let your light shine for all. Other Salian graduating class of 2021, we are here today to affirm and celebrate the light that you are and the light you have been for this college community. Your good deeds, your resilience, your definite sense of humor, and your faith throughout what has been a most challenging period has been a light for all of us. Now our world has changed, and you have confronted the challenges that have beset us. And you have set aside your fears and moved on. And as one in spirit, you have led the way. I often say to you that we're very proud of you and we are. We are so proud of you all in the way you have been there for each other. You have reached out with a helping hand when someone has fallen. You have encouraged each other to be the best version of us. Through such challenging times, many of you have had to balance the demand of family life with the demand of college life. And you have done it with such fortitude. I have honestly been humbled by your strength and character. Now, I can't help but agree with Billy Ocean's number one song in 1985. Mr. Egan would be familiar with this. When the going gets tough. The tough get going. When the going gets tough, the tough get ready. Tough. 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 Yeah. Oh, do da, do da. That's the most important line in the song. The graduating class of 2021, we have come to an end of a wonderful Lasallian relationship. A relationship that has been nurtured by your parents' home and teaching. Mrs. Balsall, Mr. Williams, Mrs. Brandon Smith, Ms. Riakos, Ms. Blinkhorn, Ms. Georgiou in year 11, Mrs. Pegerman, Mr. Brown, and many of your teachers, past and present. We are also very grateful for the support of Mr. Egan, Mr. Dad, and the executive, and this is important, for their trust in us, which has allowed us to grow. The office staff are just beautiful people, forever supporting our needs. And I have to say a special thank you to Mrs. Saliba for her humble support. Over the years, this relationship has been founded on trust and hope. I trust that each and every one of you here will believe that you can make a difference in this crazy world. I trust that you will continue to be grateful for all the blessings we take for granted. And we hope that you all have a beautiful life. Because a beautiful life doesn't just happen. It is built daily by prayer, humility, sacrifice, love, laughter, patience, grace, and goodness. Team East, you have received a hearing as a gift from the college, on which there is a symbol of a goose and the word shine. Take with you the lessons from the goose. It is now time to take flight once again and journey towards your next destination. And may a beautiful life be with you all. God bless you and your family.
I now invite Mr. Egan.
Thank you, Mr. Jacobs, for such a heartfelt speech. We've got And I'm so happy to meet you into the world. It almost wasn't so. You may realize that I'm a bit beat up today. It comes after a few obstacles this year. Earlier in the year, I fractured my spine and missed out not to get outdone. Can't see it from here, but she had 40 stitches in her head 3 weeks ago. So she's been quite beat up. And then I had a close encounter with the road last week. So got a busted ankle and some ribs, but you couldn't keep me away for quits. You are very important to me as a group of young people and of parents who supported them and entrusted us here at LaSalle with your sons and daughters. It's been a very difficult year on many fronts, and yet all these difficulties over time will fade into our memories. I won't remember my injuries. Probably the only thing I will remember is the great disappointment of this year that South Sydney lost yet another grand final. When I think back over your landmark years at school, I go firstly back to year 7 in 2016. And what a year that was. Another 2-point grand final. The Cronulla Sutherland Sharks defeated the Melbourne Storm. Our Prime Minister was Malcolm Turnbull, the Deputy Prime Minister was Barnaby Joyce, and the Opposition Leader was Bill Shorten. Perhaps one of the most significant things that happened was that Britain voted to leave the European Union and Donald Trump won the US presidency. Things changed quite quickly. When you were in kindy in 2009, we had another global pandemic. Swine flu in that past. It was also the year that Barack Obama was inaugurated, the 44th president, and Michael Jackson died. The Prime Minister here was Kevin Rudd. The opposition leader was Malcolm Turnbull. Things changed quickly. In the year you were born, most of you 2003 or 2004, we had another pandemic. It was the bird flu one. There were deadly terror attacks around the room, and there was the Space Shuttle Columbia disaster. All these things now distant memories. But the good things, tracking back through those years. Your birth, obviously, a great celebration for your family. For your parents, your first days of school, kindergarten, a huge transition. Particularly for the staff here, but also your parents and yourselves. Your first days of high school marked you as a landmark group coming into this community. You belong. You've made this place what it is. In the time you've been here, we've largely rebuilt the property, but the property really doesn't matter. What matters is the people. What matters is how you've emerged from all these things that shape you. They don't determine you, they shape you along the way. You've heard a number of times our catch cry mention that we're on about commitment, confidence, and success. Your commitment has brought you all here today. Your confidence shows on your faces, despite the masks. And it's great to see you living that out. And the confidence in your parents' faces as they look upon you as you become the best that they could have hoped for from young people that they brought into the world. If there's one good thing about this time of pandemic, it's been that it's enabled us to focus much more on the family. Indeed, our Pope declared this year as a year of the family. And in his famous document on the family, issued 4 or 5 years ago, he gave a quote that was actually part of it, was up on the board at the start of the Mass. And I'll leave you with this quote. Let us make this journey as families. Let us keep walking together. What we've been promised is greater than we can imagine. May we never lose heart because of our limitations, or ever stop seeking that fullness of love and communion which God holds out before us. Year 12 class of 2021, I thank you and I commend you, and I wish all God's blessings on you as you leave this place of learning and commence the rest of your life. I commend your parents too for the trust you've shown in us to help the students along the way. And I wish you all the good things that can come your way. Thank you.
Thank you, Stephen. We're up to the thanks for the day. Thank you, Father Ronnie. I believe you're still in the room. For the wonderful celebration of the Year 12's final mass together, and for the constant support you offer our LaSalle community. Thank you, Father. I was here to Mr. Jacobs and the Year 12 homeroom teachers, my thanks. To Mr. Stradwick and Mr. Jacobs for the wonderful liturgy and music. Ms. Rajuti and Ms. Breda for the IT and audio support, and Mr. Howich for filling the proceedings this morning, and Mrs. Wood for photography. To Mrs. Saliba and the office staff for the amazing weeks, probably months, of work behind the scene preparation for booklets, folders, perhaps a better word, certificates, medallions, and gifts. Please be upstanding. No, please don't. We're now going to watch the Year 12 montage, and we'd like to thank Dumit Eltahan for this. Mr. George, would you like to say?
I wish there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you've actually left them.
Oh, remember that video?
As we keep on saying, it's been a funny year, but we shall still celebrate LaSalle Cup. LaSalle is enormously proud of a house system which is designed to motivate, engage, and reward the students across a variety of curricula and co-curricular areas to build teamwork, self-discipline, and a sense of LaSallean pride. The last 2 years have been difficult to execute this race to win the LaSalle Cup, but without further ado. And it's a bit unusual this year. In fourth place, Turong. In third place, Benelde. Now, second and first were very, very close, both in the 4,000 points. I think there was only about 10 points in the end. There's always a winner. Will I go first? First. Okay. In first place. Yes. Yes, Captain, please come forward. Well, the South Cup isn't actually here, so for the photo, I will just take one of the cups and give them to you, okay?
Yeah, Jules.
So it'll be interesting, Victoria and Jeremy, to see what 2022 brings us, because that was a surprise this year. It was great to see. I now call Mr. Jenkins back to those podium first.
Yes, sir. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to call on the U12 homeroom team to complete their final homeroom roll call. Now, could I ask each student whose name is called to proudly respond with the present once their name is called? So, could I invite from 12.1, please, Mrs. Paul?
It's been a pleasure being your homeroom teacher for the past 2 years. I feel honoured to have had the opportunity to watch you grow into intelligent and resilient young men and women. I'm so proud of every single one of you
I wish you good luck as you begin this new chapter in your life, and God bless. As I call your name, just stand up and say present. Nicholas Abdenor. George Al-Khalil. Christina Ruesca. Jessica Calatis. Kayla Dong. Edmund Gannon. Stefan Rostanovsky. Dunya Hamzi. Jamie Jaja. Teresa Palocco. Pierre Lishwood. Grace Lee. Sandy Ma. Luca Makovsky.
Present.
Charbel Mahana. Maximo Morelli. Alexander Newland. Diaz Moore.
Present.
Dylan Pan. Joey Rahal.
Present.
Hayden Sleeman. Anna Tran. Marianne Gillespie. Thank you so much. I now call on Ms. Riakos.
During our 3 years together, the students of 12.2 have consistently demonstrated qualities that have made me proud to be their teacher. Kindness, empathy, generosity, and humor, to name a few. I will miss each student with their own unique personality that made past school so enjoyable. What I definitely won't miss is having to take the role and provide announcements around the real issues of the world, namely the EPL soccer score of the morning. 12-2, I am so proud of the young adults you have become. Good luck with the next exciting chapter of your lives. I know you have all the tools that you need to succeed. I'll now take our final roll call. Jocelyn Abosad. Marcus Batchu.
Present.
Chloe Bozanowska. Christian Sverdanovsky. Sophia Effendi. Samuel Gunawan,
yes.
Justin Hanna, Malika Aisha, Ella Jabor, John Kanan, Jack Lee, Daniel Mack, Peter Martiu,
present.
George Mensah, Huey Newman, Andre Novacheski, Anthony Sava, Michael Sturgeonovsky, Brendan Trong, and Bill Burke. Thank you, 12.2. I now call on Ms. Barrington Smith.
Good morning, everyone. It's been an absolute honour and privilege to journey with 12-3 the last 2 years. I applaud their courage under fire. Choir from me, first of all, every morning nagging them about hair, earrings, beards, lateness, just generally nagging them, really. So thank you for that. And your courage under fire for coping with COVID. Unfortunately, it did mean our time was cut short, but I do know that wherever you go and whatever you do, you will be successful as you are amazing young men and women. So I now call on my last roll call of 12-3. Anthony Chidato.
Present.
Jack Dow. Jack B. Beatrice Dos Santos de Ribeiro, Hamza El Haj, Jack Galvin Valencia,
present.
Laura Hanna, Joseph Perez, Joseph Campbell, Anastasia Lejmanovska, Nanda McGill, Erin McMullen, Milan Maletic, Eric Nguyen, Martina Nguyen, Harriet Owusu, Christian Timan, Martin Tran, and Kevin Chu. Congratulations and good luck.
So I've been fortunate to be here since 2017. So I've had a year, a home year every year since then. So I've been fortunate to know these guys since year eight. And it's, I feel like I've almost learned more than what they have as a staff member. We would have thought that almost any object in the world could be going to live it from. All of these actually people in this world will think the bullets are a premiership fans. I've listened to all. I've now heard every single absentee reason or paid reasoning. Yes, sure. But it gives me the greatest time to call the roll call one more time for 11.4.
12.4.
Yes, sir. This. Loren Alasbra. Charbel Attila. Jessica Bowie. Daniel Shaheen.
Present.
Steven Elta Han.
Present.
Aaron Woody.
Present, sir.
Cameron in the back.
Yeah.
Marcus Hay. Rudy Kao. Dana Landon. Natalie Lalani.
Present.
Present.
Patrick McIntyre, Savannah Rednoski, Eric Newman, Vin Newman, George Anna Saratora, David Zabaki Kinduaki, Jason Tran,
yes,
and Tavita Chapala.
Good morning. I had the pleasure of taking over 12.5 this year as my homeroom from Ms. Georgie, who let them go quite reluctantly. I taught some of these students in the junior years, and I've seen them go through a lot of changes this last couple of years. Some questionable haircuts, but also I've seen them grow into some mature young men and women. I haven't had the chance to spend a lot of time with them this year, unfortunately, only two terms, given the circumstances, but I've been happy to get to know them for those two terms as they complete their schooling journey. So, 12.5. Alex Valeri.
Present.
Tiana Sipkosso.
Present.
Jessica Duffy.
Present.
Julie Francis.
Present.
Rose Jihan.
Present.
Jerome George. Leo Erko. Raj Dinkle. Amina Kaloku. Sean McCurry. Sean Lee.
Present.
Elvis Y.
Present.
Ms. Vinda Nair, Ethan Ewan,
present.
Jason Nair,
present.
Isabella Silvera, and Martina Villagena. Thank you, Tom.
take this opportunity to invite Mr. Brown.
I haven't been in this library for very long. We've had a lot of interruptions with the youth. But I know this group have not only achieved the HSC, but they've also managed to get themselves a qualification and a job in their chosen field. They've also had many nominations and awards, and that's where I get to see and learn all their faces. I know they've all worked very hard to make a future for themselves, and as soon as they finish school, they're already out there working and going on to complete their training. Whether it's in auto construction, plumbing, or in a kitchen in one of Australia's best restaurants, I wish them all the best for the future. So with that, I'll have my name. John Benitez.
Present.
George David. Present. Joseph David. Julianne Habak.
Present.
Brown. And last, Marco Beavich.
Thank you for a wonderful 6 years together. In 12, we now come to the end of the ceremony. Could we please be upstanding for the very last time or get to stand to our
Thank you.
Thank you.